Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. In today's video, I'll show you how to host your website on your Synology NAS with a free SSL setup kit. And that will be without opening any port on your router. First, we'll set up a simple website by using single index.php, and then we will set up a database and install WordPress on it. That should cover the complete process, including the installation of Apache Server, MariaDB, an open source DB management system, and phpMyAdmin, which is a user-friendly GUI to manage your databases. We will be using WebStation package to manage your websites. Since I mentioned free SSL certificate without opening any port on your router, so we will be using Cloudflare tunnels for this. So, what do we need? All we need is a Synology NAS and your own domain name. Rest, I'll show you the complete process to host your website on your NAS within few minutes. If you don't have a Synology NAS, I have created a video on how you can make your old PC a Synology NAS and install DSM on it. Link in the description. Alright, let's start the video. The first step is to install WebStation from Package Center, so go to Package Center on your Synology NAS and look for WebStation. Click on Install to install it. It might take a few seconds to download and install the package. Once the installation is complete, you should be able to see a new shared folder called Web with the default index.html. By default, all the domains pointed to your NAS will be landing in this folder. We'll learn how to set up dedicated folder for each website or domain in this root folder. So ideally, you should have a dedicated folder for each site you want to host. We will discuss this in detail later in the video. If you browse the IP address of your NAS, you should see this default index.html page. But this page is only accessible locally within your own network. Let's make it accessible over the internet. For this, we need to use Cloudflare and set up a tunnel. The advantage of using Cloudflare tunnels here is we will not have to open any port ATR443 on our router to access our website. Also, we'll get free SSL certificate. That means our connection will be secured and encrypted. I have created a very detailed video on how to set up Cloudflare tunnel in Synology NAS, so I'll quickly go through these steps. But if you need to see detailed video on the topic, I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Go to Cloudflare website and log into your account. Create a free account if you don't have one already. Under websites, click add a site. Enter your domain name and follow these steps to point your domain name to Cloudflare servers. Again, please refer to the video in the description if you need help in setting up your domain on Cloudflare. Once your domain name is active, click on your domain name. On the right hand side menu, click on Access, then launch Zero Trust. Select your account. Click on Networks. You should land on a tunnels page. Click on a created tunnel, select Cloudflare, and then click next. Give your tunnel a name, I'll call it Think Smart Home. Then click save tunnel. Now you need to choose environment where your connector will be installed. Select Docker. Since we are going to use Container Manager on Synology NAS to run this tunnel, you should see a Docker run command. Copy the command and go back to your Synology NAS. I would assume you have already installed Container Manager on your Synology NAS. Head to Package Center and install it from there if you haven't done that already. Start the Container Manager. Go to Registry. Search for Cloudflare and download it. Choose the tag for variant, I'll choose latest. The download will start and it might take some time to complete. Once the download is complete, select the container and click on Run. Give your container a name. Enable Auto Start checkbox to make sure the container starts if your NAS reboots. Click Next. Scroll all the way down until you see execution command. Here we need to use the command we copied from Cloudflare account, but we need to modify it a bit. So open a notepad and paste the command we copied earlier from Cloudflare website. Remove everything before tunnel and also remove no auto update. Copy the remaining command and go back to container manager and paste it in there. Click Next and then click Done. Click on container to check the status of container, which should be green. That means it's up and running. Go back to your Cloudflare portal and under connector, you should see the status is connected. So our tunnel is also up and running. Click on Next. Here you can select your domain name, which you just added to your Cloudflare account. And now we need to link it to your service. In this case, the service is our Synology NAS. So for service type, select HTTP and under URL, enter IP address of your Synology NAS. Once the IP address is added, click on Save Tunnel. Your tunnel is added and your domain name is now pointed to your Synology NAS. Let's test it. I'll browse my domain name and it should land on the default web session page which we saw earlier by calling the IP address of our NAS. There you go. Our domain name is now pointed to our Synology NAS and our default site is now accessible over the internet. You can also verify the connection. It's secure and encrypted. I hope you are liking the video. Please take some time to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video about smart home automation, storage, and network security. Alright, let's go back to web session and install some packages which are required to run our website on Synology NAS. On the overview tab, you should see some backend packages and then some services packages. We will have to install some of these, so let's start with the backend packages. Here we will need Apache Web Server 2.4 and PHP version 8. You can install other versions of PHP too, but I'll pick version 8. Click on the link next to Apache Server, which will take you to Package Center, and then you can install it from there. Do the same with PHP version 8 by going to Package Center and installing it from there again. Once installation is complete for PHP, search for MariaDB and install it. Download might take a few seconds to complete. Once this is done, setup will ask you to set up a password. I highly recommend using a strong password and saving it in your password manager. You will need this password in the next step when we will install PHP MyAdmin. You can also change this password later by going to MariaDB package. Click Next and then click Done. Installation of MariaDB might take some time. While we are waiting for this, please like this video and hit the subscribe button. Alright, MariaDB installation is now complete. Go back to web session for last package installation under the service packages. This is PHP MyAdmin. Install PHP MyAdmin as we installed Apache and PHP earlier. Once the installation is complete, open PHP MyAdmin and log in using root as your username and using the password you set up for MariaDB. You should see PHP MyAdmin GUI and here we can manage all our databases. We'll come back to this later. For now, let's go back to web session. A quick tip, sometimes we need to add some PHP extensions and modify some variables within PHP config. You can do that easily by going to script language settings and then select the default PHP profile and then click on edit and click on extensions, and you should see all the available extensions. If you need to add any extension, you can select it and then click save. Same goes for variable. If you want to modify anything, go to core tab and update your settings and click save. I'll briefly explain web service and web portal for now. We will use these both in action soon. Web service is a set of settings for the website based on what type of website we are hosting, for example a static HTML or a dynamic PHP based website. It also contains a path for the document root where all the files are placed. Web portal is then used to access the web service using a dedicated hostname. Now, first step is to create a root folder for the website under the shared folder called web. So using the file station, go into shared folder web and create a folder for your website name. I'll name it Think Smart Home. Alright, let's create a basic redirect page which will redirect my domain name, in fact the subdomain, to my YouTube channel. I have already created a folder called YouTube with an index.php file. I'll copy the folder into our main domain website folder, which is Think Smart Home, under the shared folder called web. Just to show you, this folder only contains an index.php file which will perform a simple header redirect. We need to create a new web service and link that to our web portal. So let's create a web service. Under type, select the native script language website. Click next. Give your service a name. You can pick any name you want. I'll call it thinksmarthome_YouTube. Then select the document root. I'll browse to the folder which I just pasted inside our main website folder. Each web service will look for its own specific folder. Even though I have created these subfolders under the same website folder for better organization, but in theory, these can be placed anywhere in web shared folder directly as long as document root in the web service is set correctly. Next, I'll select Apache as my backend server. Click Next and click Create. The system will give you an info pop-up that all permissions will be adjusted automatically. If this doesn't work for you, you might have to give read permissions to your HTTP user group for this folder. Click OK. Alright, the web service is now created. Let's create a web portal for this web service. Select the service which we just created for YouTube. For portal type, select the name base and enter your domain name or subdomain. I'll enter my subdomain youtube.thinksmarthome.net. Click create. Alright, now we need to go back to Cloudflare portal and add above subdomain as a public host name and link it to our NAS. Under tunnel, I'll add a public host name. For the subdomain, I'll enter YouTube. And then select the domain name from the drop down. Service type will be HTTP and URL will be IP address of your Synology NAS. Let's test it now. My subdomain youtube.thinksmarthome.net should now land on my YouTube channel. Alright, as you can see, we have hosted a very basic website on our Synology NAS which is redirecting traffic from my website to my YouTube channel. Let's go one step further and install WordPress on our NAS. So go to WordPress website and download the latest WordPress. I have already downloaded it, so I'll just upload it to my Synology NAS in the folder which I created earlier for my website, Think Smart Home. Extract the contents of the folder. You should see a folder called WordPress. Let's rename it to WP. Alright, so now we need to repeat the same steps to create web service for WordPress. I'll quickly do that since we have already covered this while setting up our subdomain earlier in the video. Web service is created. Now let's create the web portal. For web portal, select the service which we just created, and for host name, enter the domain name. I'll enter thinksmarthome.net and click create. Since our main domain is already added as a public host name on our Cloudflare, so we don't need to do anything here. Let's test it. Alright, as you can see, the WordPress installation is trying to kick in, but due to MySQL PHP extension missing, it cannot start. To install this PHP extension, let's go back to our web station. Under script language settings, select default PHP profile and click edit. Click extensions, select MySQL and click save. That's it. Extension is installed. Go back to installation page and then refresh it. You should now see the WordPress is ready for installation. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. Alright, here we need to create a database for WordPress. Since we have already installed MyADB and phpMyAdmin earlier, now it's time to use them. So open phpMyAdmin, enter the username as root and the password which we set up while setting up MyADB. Once you are in, under databases, enter the database name and click create. Database is created. Now we need to create a user and give him a complete control of this database. So under privileges, click add user account. Give it a name. For host name, type localhost, since this database will be hosted locally within the NAS. I'll generate a random password. Make sure to copy this because you will need this to start the installation. I would recommend saving it in your password manager. You should also be able to see this password in wp-config files. Make sure the checkbox to grant all privileges on database is checked and then click go. Database is now ready for WordPress. Let's go back to installation page. Enter the database name which we created and then enter the username and then the password. Leave remaining setting as is and click submit. If you see an error unable to write wp-config.php file, make sure your user HTTP has read and write permission on your site directory. You can verify that by going to properties of the folder and then permission. Make sure your user HTTP can read and write the folder. Once the permissions are updated, go back and refresh the page again. You should see the sunshine. Run the installation. Here you'll need to enter details for your website and create admin account. Enter the title, admin username, password and the email address. And finally, click install WordPress. Installation might take some time. While this is happening, please take some time to give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video about smart home automation, storage, and network security. Alright, the WordPress is installed and now you can log in to your admin portal. Here, you can visit the website and install plugins and do all sorts of things here. Quick couple of tips before I wrap up this video. It is recommended to use UPS with your Synology NAS if you are hosting your websites on it. This is to avoid downtime in case of momentary power failure. Also, since you have opened up your NAS under public host name, I'll recommend to enable DDoS protection under security. You can also use Cloudflare DDoS protection feature. Alright, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.